Welcome back to yet another part of Top 50 Excel Shortcut Series. If you have not seen the earlier part of this series, then please see it because you are missing something very important. I have provided the link of the same in the description box below. This is the sixth part of the series, so stay tuned. Hello, I'm your tutor and welcome to my channel Learn in 5 Minutes. So let's start. Number 25. Accept function with autocomplete. When you are entering a function, Excel will try to guess the name of the function you want and present an autocomplete list for you to select from. The question is, how do you accept one of the options displayed and yet still in edit mode? The trick is to use the tab key. When you press tab, Excel adds any parentheses as needed, then leaves the formula bar active so that you can fill in the arguments as needed. On a Mac, you need to use the down arrow key first to select the function you want, then tab. Number 26. Insert rows or columns. To insert a row or column with a keyboard shortcut, you need to first select an entire row or column respectively. The shortcut to insert row or column is Ctrl Shift Plus in Windows and Command Shift Plus in Mac. Shortcut is the same whether you are inserting rows or columns. The shortcut inserts rows if rows are selected and columns if column is selected. With an entire row selected, this shortcut will insert a row above the selected row. With an entire column selected, this shortcut will insert a column to the right of the selected column. You can also insert multiple rows and columns. Just select the number of rows or columns you want to insert before using a shortcut. I have also written down the shortcut to select entire row and column on screen, just in case you don't know it beforehand. Number 27. Delete rows or columns. For deleting rows and columns, first select entire row or column. Once you have a row or column selected, the shortcut for deleting rows or columns is Ctrl minus in Windows and Command minus in Mac. With this same shortcut, you can also delete multiple rows and columns. Just select the number of rows or columns you want to delete, then use the shortcut. In case you don't have an entire row or column selected when you use the shortcut, Excel will present the delete dialog box, which contains options for deleting rows and columns along with the shifting of cells. Number 28. Hide and unhide columns. To hide one or more columns, use the shortcut Ctrl 0 in both the platforms. Any columns that intersect the current selection will be hidden. If you prefer, you can also first select entire columns before using this shortcut. To unhide columns, you must first select cells that span either side of the hidden column or select columns that span the hidden columns. Then use the keyboard shortcut Ctrl Shift 0 in both the platforms. Number 29. Hide and unhide rows. To hide one or more rows, use the shortcut Ctrl 9 in both the platforms. Any rows that intersect the current selection will be hidden. You can also first select one or more entire rows if you prefer. To unhide rows, you must first select rows that span either side of the hidden row or select entire rows that span the hidden rows. Then use the key shortcut Ctrl Shift 9.
I hope this shortcut will change the way you work in Excel. If you found this video useful, please like and share this with your friends. And if you have not subscribed to this channel, do it right now and press the bell icon beside the subscribe button, so that you don't miss on any new videos that I upload.
See you soon in the next video with part 7 of this series. Thanks for watching.